You think you outsmarted me, the mighty Mordred? I don't think so, Yoked Girth!
Stay tuned for what happens next on Yoked Girth. Now a word from our sponsor.
Kids, are you ready for a new wild and wacky puncho fruit flavor? Introducing Apricot. It's a punch to the gut.
So stop by, fill up, and make sure you get your Billy Hog hot dog before you jet away.
Good morning, Brook Hollow. Today is October 20, 1990. This is your news. We have a special breaking report. The police department has released information that more local teenagers have gone missing. They were last seen earlier this week, and the only connection between the teenagers is that they are all students at Brook Hollow High School. This could be linked to the disturbing trend of other possible abductions and missing teenagers from our otherwise quiet town. If anyone has seen the teenagers or has any other information, please contact the police department. The mayor of Brook Hollow has put a curfew into effect for anyone under 18 starting tonight. Now to other news. In the business world, offered practical technology.
Where am I? Are those roots? Nah, can't be. But this must be one of those prank TV shows. Alright, be cool, Max. You're gonna be famous.
Signal detected.
What was that? Some sort of radio signal? I wonder where it's coming from. Nah. This isn't looking good, Max. It's a speedy little green corn puff.
Thank you.
Well, someone had to have set up all this sciencey stuff here. But still, I'm not exactly sure where this is and what is going on. I should keep looking around. Whoa, look at the size of that ant. Honestly, I'm just glad it's not big enough to squish me.
Science!
What is that? Showtime. Just like laser tag. Nothing happened. Looks like the other two lasers are blocked. After all that buildup, this big mysterious computer doesn't do anything. Man. Looks like that little red thing's itching for a fight. Food. Come here, you little green sausage.
flash.
I can't really describe how terrible this tastes.
Hey, buddy. Clogs now?
Something that sounded like a big far-off explosion. I don't want any trouble, Aunt. What the heck? Is something burrowing under there?
Oh, it's getting dark. Should probably find somewhere to crash. Meals on wheels.
Science.
They never told me science could be this exciting. Where are you off to, Aunt? This place is getting pinker by the minute. Man. I'm not picky.
I have isolated the source of the particle irregularities. They appear to be a byproduct of the shrinking process. If I adjust the machine to account for their existence, it should be the key to the de-shrinking, expanding process. Burgle, please bring up the readings for the irregular covalent SNPI-42Z particle traces. Ugh, that name is going to get tiresome. And while you're at it, rename all references to the irregular covalent SMPI-42Z particle to Raw Science.
Order received. Raw Science identified. Does it require cooking, flipping, or grilling?
No, none of those. Categorization.
That answer is not permitted, according to health code standards governing the handling of raw food items. System reboot in progress. Thanks for the helping hand. I am Burgle, acting science manager for this project. I am also a robot. I am sure this all must be very disorienting for you, but hopefully I can explain. you were miniaturized by Dr. Tully's spacer device. Why are you here in the yard? I do not know. In fact, I cannot seem to recall much of anything. A recent power surge has caused a massive raw science containment explosion. This, and what's worse, the explosion has disrupted my computing power. My memory banks are corrupted. Sorry to pile on the bad news, my new friend. How can I be of service? It seems you and I are both a little discombobulated. Given my best calculations, your biomass has been subject to covalent spacing reduction via interatomic energy extraction. In other words, you have been shrunk. It is likely this was achieved using Dr. Wendell Tully's spacer platform, patent pending. Shrinking can be a traumatic experience for tiny human brains, and memory loss is a known side effect. Hopefully, your memory will return in time. You are here, in the Oak Lab, built and used by Dr. Wendell Tully to experiment on all things small. This is the base of operations for conducting experiments in his yard. Dr. Tully is a brilliant scientist and inventor. He is also my creator. My initial protocol was to serve as the short-order cook of the future. However, I have been recently promoted to acting science manager to assist with his experiments. No doubt my previous work experience has been invaluable to Dr. Tully. Although, now that I am processing it, I have not seen him for several weeks. And now I cannot recall where he went. It must be my corrupted memory banks. To return to your prior size, you would need to successfully activate Dr. Tully's Unfortunately, my readings indicate it is inoperable. It appears to have suffered several malfunctions from the explosion. I am sorry, but it appears you may be stranded here for some time until we find a solution. Haha! That is a great idea! Let me run a full diagnostic scan on it and see what we need to do to get it fixed up. Processing! Memory fault. Code 408B3000. Ominent OS script runtime error. Arg! I am sorry again. It appears I have sustained more damage to my memory chip without those memories. I do not know how to repair the spacer. Dr. Tully used two types of chips to back up my memory. Auxiliary chips are small capacity chips used to store project data. If you find these, I should be able to help you learn new survival recipes. Super chips are special, and they are gold! They back up full directories of my memory system. If we are going to fix the spacer, that data is bound to be on a super chip. I suggest exploring the other labs in the backyard. Return with any memory chips you find. Dr. Tully has built many more labs throughout the yard. Each lab is used for various experimental procedures. I can upload their locations to your scabby. Stand processing. Processing. Error. Files not found. Cheese and fries. The lab locations are missing from my memory, but we are in luck. I was able to retrieve the location of one of the facilities, the Hedge Lab. The Hedge Lab is the observation center of the yard and used for research on arachnid webbing. You will find the hedge near the house if you head southeast. The lab is located deep inside the hedge, sending the coordinates to your scabby. Try to find the Hedge Lab first, but there is nothing stopping you from searching the yard for the other labs. Except, of course, thousands of... That reminds me. Dr. Tully locks the important labs with biometric scanners. You will need access. Head over to the ASL terminal and place your hand on the biometric scanner near it. Give it a moment to sync your signature into the mainframe. Once you are registered, you will be granted access to... ASL grants access to daily work items. Nay, tasks. Nay, quests. Yes, quests. I will reward you raw science for each completed quest. In my science shop, you can trade raw science back for survival recipes from experiments that Wendell conducted when you log onto the ASL terminal over there. Unless you have any other questions, You really should get started finding those shit. Have an exponentially great day!
Science, you are off the hook.
This morning, I installed the borrowed lab modules, another one of my forgotten inventions from the early days. I had such grand notions back then. The Kinder Science Mini-Quick Little Chemist Lab educational toy for children. But no, Wendell, we can't possibly put hydrochloric acid into the hands of children. The lawyers will never agree. It's a good thing I never told them about the Bunsen burners. Odd that Ominent has been using my toy pieces in this way. I digress. The lab network is now up and running in the backyard. I'm planning to dedicate each one of them to a different function. Main power will run through here, the Oak Lab, as the center of operations for the backyard. The second lab is nestled into the hedge. Such wonderful views from up there. Side note, I'm worried that Ominent's shoddy manufacturing of the lab pieces will cause them to fall apart over time, but they will do for now.
Science!
Hey there, buddy.
Science!
Meals on wheels.
Thank you.
Snuffling along here.